Breaking news tonight in the Gabby Petito investigation. Brian Laundrie is now a wanted man. A grand jury has indicted Laundrie for use of unauthorized access devices. Officials say Laundrie got $1,000 or more from a debit card that wasn't his after August 30th. Investigators did not say who the card belonged to. We reached out to Brian's family attorney. He confirms the warrant is related to activities that happened after Gabby's death. We asked the lawyer if the cards used were Gabby's, but he would not comment.
As the search for Brian Laundrie now turns into a manhunt, memorials for Gabby are growing across the country. Gabby's hometown of Blue Point, New York, set up this beautiful tribute today. But Gabby's family wants more. They want answers. NBC2's Megan Myers is talking to Gabby's great aunt about the search for Laundrie.
Gabby Petito's great aunt, Jill Hengel, says she'll never forget her sweet smile. As her whole family grieves, they're also filled with a lot of frustration as law enforcement continues to search for Brian Laundrie.
I'm just mad. I'm very mad.
The person most likely to have answers as to what happened to Gabby Petito is nowhere to be found.
Do you think that he's in that reserve that they're searching?
No. No, I don't think so.
Hengel says she believes Laundrie could be anywhere at this point.
How can you not say anything?
Her whole family is distraught, remembering Petito as artistic, talented, and adventurous, eager to see the world.
You would have fell in love with her right away, because that's the type of person she was.
When the FBI confirmed the body recovered in Wyoming was Petito's and ruled her death a homicide, Hengel was filled with emotion.
I screamed. I was very angry. And I wanted to punch him through a wall. You're on the run for something that may have been an accident or what? Just let us know.
She thinks Laundrie's parents have information they're not sharing. They told police the last time they saw their son was last Tuesday. They said he was going for a hike in the Carlton Reserve, the 25,000 acres of wooded land. Crews plan to search again tomorrow.
Please, if you know where your son is or you know anything, please come forward.
And as for Laundrie,
if you could, what would you say to Brian?
I don't know. I just don't know what I would say.
And
I'm shaking just thinking about it.
In Northport, Megan Myers, NBC2.
For 5 days now, 75 people across 16 agencies have been searching every inch of the Carlton Reserve, trying to find Laundrie. And the conditions are brutal for the teams. Once you get past the heat and humidity, 75% of the park is underwater, so teams are facing gators and snakes. And this is not cheap. A local search and rescue group president estimates up to $150,000 is being spent every day, meaning the search for Brian could cost upwards of $1 million just so far.
As far as, you know, just, you know, Northport and Sarasota County, this is one of the biggest searches I've seen in a long time.
I just hope they have a really good reason for being out there this long. This is hazarding a lot of people and a lot of stuff, and just wondering why.
We asked Sarasota County how much the search has cost the sheriff's office. They say they haven't yet added up all the hours and overtime.
Brian Laundrie's parents returned to their home in Northport tonight. Earlier today, police escorted them away from their home. We're not sure where they went. Now, a lot of you are asking whether Brian's parents could face criminal charges along with their son. We asked FGCU professor Pamela C.A. She says if the Laundries knew of a crime and then helped Brian hide from police or destroy evidence, they could face serious consequences.
If these parents have protected their son inappropriately, they could look at anywhere from 5 to 15 years of prison or probation.
The Laundries did get that silver Ford Mustang back that the FBI towed away earlier this week.
The city of Moab, Utah is investigating its police department's handling of this incident between Brian and Gabby. Every minute of this body cam video has been scrutinized since Gabby disappeared. Some are praising the officers, others criticizing their response. In a statement, the city of Moab says it's unaware of any break of police department policy.
The turmoil in Brian and Gabby's relationship did not end in Moab. A couple from Louisiana was on vacation in Wyoming. Last month, they saw Gabby and Brian. This was right before she disappeared. They say Gabby was in tears and Brian was visibly angry at the staff of a restaurant they were eating in. The restaurant, the Merry Piglets, released a statement on Instagram confirming Gabby and Brian were there and that they've notified the FBI of what they saw.
Be the first to know the newest developments in the search for Brian Laundrie. All you need to do is download the NBC2 News app. You can check out timelines, new sightings, and much more. The app is free to download.